So what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. I hope you are having an amazing day. And in today's video, we are going to be taking a look at the official beta 2 for the Galaxy S9 Plus based on One UI. So I was supposed to be uploading this like 2 days earlier, but I just got busy in my work. And then again, it was a bit harder to get hold of this build because again, these are not released in India. If you don't already know, this is a G965FD, the Exynos Indian model. As this is a beta 2, I mean, it was a huge upgrade. It was like almost 700 MB of OTA. Still, it doesn't bring a whole lot of changes to the table. So I'm just going to explain the newer changes and just the changes which I actually forgot to mention in my last video. So let's just begin. First of all, with the home screen, again, as you can see, no changes at all, but the animations do feel much more smoother and quicker than before. I mean, they have lessened the eye candy of this ROM. There were so many animations and there is actually an option to reduce animations, which I really don't expect to use as a daily driver. I paid 65,000 rupees for this phone. I want this phone to look its best. But still, the animations were too much for my liking. So then again, they have just quickened the animation. Still, there are major lags in the notification panel when you have more than like 5 to 6 notifications. Yeah, it's extremely weird that even like MIUI 10 devices which are running on like Snapdragon 625 are much more smoother than this thing. And as we already know, One UI isn't actually coming to the A series or the J series or something, because Samsung even knows they couldn't be able to handle this blur stuff and everything. So yeah, they would be just getting the normal Pi update, and only the S8, Note 8, S8 Plus, S9, S9 Plus and the Note 9 would be getting this UI and the folding phone that it's coming. And then again, if you want the same build as mine, I can't actually post a full ROM link or something. But what can I do is post update.zip for this thing, which would be the OTA of it. So if you're already on the ZRKA, which I made a complete video. So if you're on any kind of S9, you can actually install that update. As I showed in that video, that you can just go to the recovery and choose the update zip. You have to do same for it. Once you go onto the ZRKA, then you can upgrade to the ZRKL. You have to just download the zip in the description and you would get to the beta 2. So let's just begin again, going to the apps. You have again the crappy looking kids like icons. I mean, there are more of them, as you can see, the video and stuff is also updated. I mean, the music app is also updated to the Pi, but the icon is still older, which is a bit weird. Then again, you have video apps and stuff. Again, it's completely black, just like the gallery. As you can see, it's still black, but I really missed my scrolling. Yeah, I really loved it. But as you can see, it just glitches the newer UI. That's why I guess Samsung has removed it, but the clock. The clock is now wider. Now, if you're thinking this is a glitch, no. The clock is now switched to the white theme, which I seriously don't know why. I mean, I guess Samsung wants you to use the night mode more, because if you burn your eyes by looking at this white thing in the darkness, surely you will use the night mode more. Just when I formatted my phone and just completed the setup and stuff, I noticed that all the features which are added into it, now this could be just a beta thing, all the features were just enabled, like everything. I didn't enable this thing, which would be the recent apps over here. I didn't enable that at all. Then again, I didn't enable any kind of unnecessary features such as lift to wake and stuff. Like literally, I have to manually go and turn it off into the motion and gestures. Again, as you can see, it's automatically there here, and all the features instead of smart stay, which will actually just cause a major battery drain, is disabled, but everything is just enabled over here, which is a bit weird. You have smart pop-up view, which I don't guess was available into the first build. I guess this was available into the hotfix OTA, which would be the beta 1.5. So let's just go to the about phone directly. As you can see, both of your IMEI slots are now present over here when compared to the first beta 1, which was also added into the hotfix. So directly going to the software information, you have One UI 1.0 Samsung Experience version 10. So many of you guys actually asked me why it still says Samsung Experience. So Samsung Experience just stands for the normal features that you get. So if any kind of other device is running on Android Pie, it must be on Experience version 10, but the UI won't look the same, but it still gets the normal features such as smart lift to wake and stuff, which is a part of the Samsung Experience, not the One UI. One UI is just this waste of space. Then again, you have November security patch, which is also updated, pretty good. But if you take a closer look at the build number, PPR1. Yes, Samsung, I guess, just thought there is no Android 9.0.1. There would be no Android 9.1. So I guess we would just irritate our users by not giving the PR2. Yes, if you don't already know, Android 9.0 Pi doesn't go above 9.0.1 or something. It's just 9.0 Pi. But there are two builds of it, the PPR1 and the PPR2. Now, the PPR2 and PPR1 are not a huge differences. There are some minor changes into the stock Android UI. Doesn't mean anything in One UI, but still, Samsung isn't giving the latest updates from the Android Pi. But as I told you, it doesn't bring major changes, but it does to the UI. So for example, if you want to switch between the apps quickly, you can just swipe around from the home button. Now, as you can see, I'm all the way to the right. Again, it's just glitched out. All the way to the right, then wow. all the way to the right, then again I can just go to the left. As you can see, it's not most polished thing. I have to go all the way around to switch all of the apps, which doesn't happen same into the PPR2. In PPR2, you have the whole bottom side to scroll around and it just works flawless. Then again, what Samsung added over here to the navbar is Android Pie has a manual rotation button if you have turned off your auto rotate. So for example, if I'm holding my device in portrait mode, if I just rotate it to the landscape, there you go, there is a button now over there. I can just tap it. So yeah, if you are just getting annoyed with the auto rotation, you can just turn off the auto rotation sensor and use this button anyways, cause it's extremely handy. I mean, I love this feature. After that, what I forgot to tell you guys is the floating keyboard. So if you don't already know, One UI is all about one-handed usage. Here is your normal keyboard. Now there would be another option over here, which would be the keyboard type. So you have your one-handed and the standard, which are the normal ones, and the floating one. The floating one does make a sense. On my Note 9 is a massive phone. Even though it's like a 0.1 inch bigger than the S9, it's a massive phone. And sometimes it does get irritating that the half of the phone is just hanging in the air and I'm just holding my phone like this. So it's much more easier to use my phone with my whole hand and just type like this, which is a very great addition by Samsung. I really love it. Now, also many of you guys asked me that, is there any kind of full camera API 2 support? And I'm happy to show you, yes, there it is. All the Samsung phones which are running Android 8.1 Oreo do have camera API 2 support, and including the S9, which did release on 8.2 Oreo and didn't have the full support, now completely gets it. So for example, going to the manual camera app, hit start. There you go, everything is supported, so you can freely enjoy any kind of Gcam which is ported from your favorite developer. But now, at least none of the Gcams work. Like, this is the most stable Gcam that I actually use on my Note 9 for my daily driver usage. Doesn't actually work. As you can see, the camera loads up, the UI loads up, but it's just force closes. And I will try my best to make it a bit more faster from the next time, as it was a bit harder for me to get hold of this beta 2. But as beta program is finally coming to the India officially, I'm extremely excited that Samsung is making this step. I surely hope that I could bring this to you guys faster, and hope you guys to see you soon. Peace.